A lot of bands are sort of taking a much more sort of DIY route than ever. How do you feel about how is that going to grow? Is that going to be sort of more entrenched? Is it, you know, a record company is going to be sort of less and less useful as they go on, or are they still going to have a place?
Yeah, I mean, I really like, obviously, I like people who do it for themselves. Again, yep. That becomes part of your character. Sure. And it's really interesting if you've managed to create a thing. You know, some bands who start their own club night, some bands who certainly have amazing visual ideas and can convey those through shirts and stuff, or amazing sleeves. Just people who can get on and find an audience on their own. I think all that is brilliant. It's... if you can make a living out of it, that's the thing, because that's what you want an artist that you like to be able to do. You yeah. want them to be able to carry on doing it and having more time to be able to do it. So I think that's all good. My real problem is there's such a gulf now between the big major labels at the top yeah. and some of the DIY operations down here, and the big labels at the top who basically control what Spotify do right. or what Apple do. Unless you're amongst them right up here and you're always on the right playlist and stuff, you might not be making money. It's the real problem. I mean, I've always hated major labels and everything, but there was a point where you thought, actually, it is going tits up for you now, isn't it? And we have we're getting to the point where it was almost more of a level playing field, you know, and Lawrence would start Domino and, you know, Beggars Group, you know, put out some really good records. You thought, yeah, we are taking the power sure. back. Now the major conglomerations are making £1 million, you know, every second on streams. They have so yeah. much power and so much budget and so much influence on then what material appears on these platforms.
And that's just by this marketing spend and all of yeah. that, and the way that they just...
Oh, God, yeah. Marketing spends. Just having a... If, you know, behind the scenes, if Spotify are trying to renew a license with a certain major label, then I imagine a certain major label are saying, well, yes, but we would like to see, please,
on the
percentage of our artists per day on yeah. this.
So they've got huge leverage that
yeah, absolutely.
Other bands just can't yeah. have. We actually talked about how the sort of algorithms were affecting the way people wrote music and changing the way they were writing for Spotify, in a sense.
Yeah.
And you said, well, if you get played over 30 seconds, it still counts for people. So actually, the length of songs were coming down because it,
yeah.
you need 30 seconds to make it count.
I can't remember whose album we reviewed the other week. Who was it? I think it's the National's new album. It's got like 18 tracks on it. But the reason it's got 18 tracks on it is so it aggregates more Spotify streams to exaggerate them up the charts. But 18 tracks, that's not a... It's just really... 18? In an age where you're saying the album is dead,
yeah,
you're now putting 18 tracks... Even Self Esteem's record, that was about 16, 17 tracks. But the idea is more tracks, more streams. And I was talking to one UK hip-hop artist who shall remain nameless. I said, I really like the EP because it's really concise. It's like the old days of punk rock, really. You've got a completely different discipline, really, in hip-hop, that you're doing everything in, you know, the longest song on his EP was 2 minutes 40 seconds. And I was going, it's great, it's really urgent. And he just looked at me as if I was bonkers and just said, we get paid after 30 seconds on Spotify. Why would you write a long song? Why just write loads of short songs? Make an album out of that. That's how you get paid. But it is, I mean, it's weird, isn't it? I mean, all the hardware does change, you know.
Yeah.
It always has.
Yeah,
from the invention for rock and roll, the 7-inch single, yeah. You know, it always changes. Even having transistor radios meant that, you know, the Beach Boys can happen because you can listen to pop music outdoors. There's always something, you know, which is a knock-on effect, but I'm not sure this knock-on effect is as artistically liberating and exciting as some.
As it might be. How grippy do you feel about live venues closing? You do a lot of stuff with the Music Venue Trust. And
yeah.
I mean, how has that affected the way you discover new music and all of that
stuff? I mean, it's hard because in, I suppose, in around the end of the 80s, early 90s, you could go to Camden and you could see 3 gigs in a night, just starting at the Camden Falcon. You go to the Black Horse en route to the Bullen Gate, and you could see, it meant you could see much more music in a night. Now you have to start off by getting a train somewhere to, you know, I don't know, in East London, in Dalston. And then if you want to see another band, you've basically got to get on another train and virtually end up in Southend. And then, you know, you'll have to get an Uber back. And you've spent £500 going out and seeing two bands who ended up being terrible. And you think, I'll do that again next week. You can't see as much. That's the real problem. And I find it very hard to really bang on about a band unless I've seen them live, because you know, bands can disguise themselves on record or send you two amazing tracks. But I think there is a tendency these days for people to get really excited by that without knowing that there's something else.
Yeah.
And what you need is that something else. So I really want to, I have to go and see a band, but it's becoming more and more difficult to find places, you know, to sweep up enough bands.
Yeah.
You wonder where the next people like us are going to find each other and form bands and start fanzines, and or even just, you know, share nights of terrific, sparkling, invigorating, informative conversation. Where is that going to happen? That real life forum. Where is that going to happen when all these places are being knocked down or turned into gastro pubs? It's upsetting to me, because I do feel like I had quite a lot of, you know, I fell into having quite a lot of chances where you made places where you could all get together.
Yeah.
And it's just getting harder and harder for people, I think, young people, to find a place that they can call their own and create a thing, because a lot of these places are being taken away from them. And no one, what makes me really grumpy is that no one in authority seems to understand or care.
Right.
I mean, there's one or two local councils who are very good and supportive, but in others, they just don't understand, they don't care, they don't see any real value in the creative element of their towns and cities.
Yeah.
Daft to me. Yeah, I'm grumpy about that.
That's absolutely right. If you had some words of advice, if you're starting out now as a band, what would be your sort of key things you'd want to sort of give a band to go away with?
Don't worry about what anyone else is doing. Some practical skills are, necessary, but just write some songs. Write a lot of songs, because if it turns out that they're really good songs, don't put all 18 of them on Spotify. If you've got a lot of good songs, you'll need them over the course of time. Write, if you can, and I always say this to kids who want to be journalists as well, or even people who want to be DJs, but certainly anything that you're writing, just make sure you do at least half an hour a day, whatever it is. Just write. Just keep writing. If you're a writer, write, even if it's just a diary. If you're writing songs, you're doing something, just fiddle around, do something every day, and so you can start throwing bits away and move on. But don't worry about what anyone else is doing, because even if you feel like you're out of fashion now, you won't be out of fashion in 2 years' time. I can pretty much guarantee that. And you might be the person who is the one thing that is, is the new and different thing which people will eventually need. I've always liked the person at the front of some sort of movement.
Yeah.
And if you can, make friends with other artists.
Yeah.
And form,
to be part of that community.
Form bonds
with
other people that you can share stuff with, even if it's ideas or stages. That, I guess, is the start. And, when you're ready, send us something.
When you're ready.
And then wait 6 months. Then send me something.